Chaotic scenes from Kenya have been seen as supporters of the opposition Raila Odinga hit the streets protesting the surging price of goods, high cost of living, among other reasons. Today, political party leaders under their umbrella body, the National Consultative Forum, met at the forum headquarters in Kabalagala to draw new strategies of averting the Kenyan incidents from happening in Uganda.
Kenya right now is demonstrating why electoral malpractice. South Africa is doing the same. Tunisia is doing the same. The uniqueness Uganda has is the formation, the establishment, constitutionalizing the National Consultative Forum. That brings political parties together to reach a consensus.
According to the National Unity Platform's Julia Mugisha, they plan to engage the leader of opposition and President Museveni to further push for the national dialogue among the political parties for the good of the Ugandans.
Indeed, there is need for dialogue. This dialogue business started way back, some time back, and it was being spearheaded by JRC, Joint Christian Council, you know, something like that. But it didn't conclude, and NCF is taking it up as a project.
The leaders are optimistic that through dialogue, the unfulfilled demands right from the previous general elections, including a peaceful transition of power, amendments in the electoral laws, and the rule of governance, among others, will be addressed.
We are pushing for transition. We are pushing for good governance. We are pushing for rule of law in this country. Those are the issues we are looking at. Because people continue to be arrested, people continue to be detained, there is no rule of law, there is corruption. There are many issues we want to talk about.
And looking at what is happening now, because of delay of dialogue in Kenya, as I speak here now, the trend is that dialogue was delayed and another thing is happening. We do not want to reach that level. We want to begin by making sure in every aspect of life we dialogue.
During this meeting, the political leaders also expressed a need for the government to put in place stringent laws against the corrupt government officials, expressing dismay over the Iron Sheet saga, where a number of government ministers have been implicated.
We are not creating enmity between the opposition and the leadership. If the president comes out of power, he will run in the opposition, and the party which will be in power will be in power when the other one is in the opposition. So we should have the relationship. It is not a war. It is not fighting. We have to look at our country for all, which is belonging to everybody. Whatever belongs to everybody belongs to nobody.
Because this one embraces members of parliament or parties with members of parliament or without members of parliament. And that one curtails its operations.
They also mentioned a number of issues to be addressed. Story by Jaliat Namoya for the news.